Hello again. This time I will talk about bacterial response to forest clear cutting, which is a part of my PhD that I'm currently doing at the Institute of Microbiology in Prague under supervision of Peter Baldrian. Before going into the bacterial community composition, I would like to point out that this study or this experiment started some time ago in our group, and it was already shown that the patterns of fungal community composition and biomass, also enzyme activities after the clear cutting of Pizza abies stand, were rather complex. So the soil was sampled for the total of 2 years after the clear cutting, where bulk soil, rhizosphere, and roots were analyzed separately. Now, the main previous findings in this study were the decline of the mass of the fine roots. It decreased by almost half 2 years after the clear cutting, and together with the increase in fungal biomass during the peak of the root decomposition, this pointed to the importance of the roots as a carbon source for saprotrophs. Moreover, there was an increase in enzyme activity of the many enzymes in the roots in the early stages of decomposition. So all of this showed us that the root litter represents a new decomposition hotspot for fungi. So naturally, we wondered what happened with bacteria. What about bacterial communities? And here we can see on this NMDS graph that there is a distinct bacterial community on the roots. We're shown here in triangles with more profound changes in time showed with different color compared to the soil and rhizosphere here. And if we look over to the relative abundance graph of the most abundant taxa, we can almost immediately notice that the roots seem to harbor a more dynamic bacterial community. And this can be confirmed by looking at the specific taxa separately, like Penibacillus, for example, or Burkholderia, and their average relative abundance, which was higher in the roots shown in blue here compared to rhizosphere and soil. And this points to their importance and possible involvement in the decomposition of root litter alongside fungi. And now looking at the indicator species analysis here on the example of roots. So we are looking at an NMDS graph where these ellipses represent 95% confidence intervals, and the red colors represent early stages of root decomposition or the early months of the sampling, while the blues represent the later stages. The size of the dots correspond to the relative abundance of the taxa. So we can see that many taxa are indicative of the later stages of root decomposition. For example, Bacillus, among the most abundant ones, a common root colonizer, was indicative of the latest month, while Dechloromonas, commonly found in soil, was indicative of the first decomposition stages. Together, our results indicate that clear cutting indeed leads to profound changes in bacterial community composition in the roots, and that specific bacterial taxa are potentially involved in the decomposition of the roots alongside fungi, and they are possibly interacting with the fungi. The change in time seems more dynamic in the roots compared to the soil, complementing the previous findings of our group. With that, I would like to thank you again for your attention, and I will be ready to take any questions. Thank you.